Do robots scare you? According to some military experts at the Future of Life Institute, they probably should. This is because the distinction between science fiction and technological fact is often hazy when it comes to warfare. The US Air Force has projected that during a hostage scenario, SWAT teams may send mechanical insects equipped with video cameras to sneak inside a building. In fact, this already exists. It's called an octoroach. It's a very little robot with a camera and radio transmitter that can cover up to 100 meters on the ground. And there's more talk of biomimetic or weapons that mimic nature on the horizon. Who knows how many dangerous animals are being used as models by cutting-edge military strategists? In a recent book, P.W. Singer and August Cole painted a vivid picture of autonomous drones, lasers, and satellites that have been taken over in the near future in which the US is at war with China and Russia. When writing this book, they made sure to create extensive footnotes that trace the history of each piece of gear and software that it covers. This further solidifies their point and prevents it from being dismissed as a techno-military dream. This leads us to the development of robotic killer robots. A Russian science fiction story from the 60s, Crabs on the Island, described a kind of Hunger Games for AIs in which robots would battle one another for resources. Losers would be scrapped and winners would spawn until some evolved to be the best killing machines. When a top computer scientist described a similar scenario as Robot Jurassic Park to the US Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, a leader there said it was highly possible. Realizing that such an experiment has the potential to spiral out of control isn't difficult. The main barrier preventing a big power from testing out such potential catastrophes is cost. And let's be honest, this obstacle really isn't an obstacle when it comes down to countries and military. A potential solution is to use software modeling to enable virtual simulations of real-world combat to motivate future military investments. In the past, nation-states have come together to explicitly forbid particularly gruesome or terrifying new weapons. International treaties outlawed biological and chemical weapons by the middle of the 20th century. The use of blinding laser technology has also been banned by the International Committee. Are killer robots next? Killer robots and other weapons that may act autonomously and without direct human direction to destroy a target have been successfully banned by the UN. This came after a lot of persistent pressure from NGOs. We can all imagine some extremely horrific types of weapons that all states should agree never to develop or use. Drones that slowly kill enemy soldiers infringe on international agreements against torture. Similarly, sonic weapons intended to damage an adversary's hearing or balance should be condemned. But if a country decides to go rogue and make their own killer robots, what do you think should happen? Many people think that the creators and users of killer robots deserve to be shunned and severely punished. After all, the thought of a killing machine being let wild is terrifying. However, many of the biggest militaries in the world seem to be lurching toward the development of such weapons by pursuing a deterrence logic. Basically, this means they're worried about other countries not sticking to the treaty and developing killer AIs. In this scenario, they want to make sure that they're completely prepared for this and able to take on such a force with their own AIs. This could lead to military-grade force within nations like the US and China. But the question stands, which is worse, a killer robot or a biological weapon? Military theorists and computer scientists are discussing this more every single day. According to Michael Schmidt of the US Naval War College, military robots can patrol the skies in order to prevent another massacre like that of Saddam Hussein against the Kurds and the Marsh Arabs. Since a robot won't be susceptible to human outbursts of rage, sadism, or cruelty, Ronald Arkin of the Georgia Institute of Technology argues that autonomous weapon systems may reduce man's inhumanity to man through technology. He suggests putting robots in charge of targeting decisions and removing humans from the process. Target clarification has also been devised by Arkin to safeguard facilities like hospitals and schools. Theoretically, it makes sense to prefer predictable human violence to controlled machine violence. Massacres that occur during time of war frequently appear to have illogical emotional roots. However, we often reserve our harshest judgment for premeditated murderers who calmly plotted their attacks rather than for acts of passion-driven violence. Massacres are more precisely organized and numerous throughout history of warfare, and it goes without saying that any robotic weapon systems would almost certainly have some sort of override feature. Any attempt to incorporate morality and the law into killer robots presents significant practical issues. Professor of Computer Science Noel Sharkey contends that it's impossible to create a robot warrior with responses to every scenario that might occur during a battle. This is the equivalent of letting a self-driving car drive through snowy conditions that cover its sensors. It's not gonna end well. In fact, many soldiers would agree that the daily life in battle consists of extended intervals of dullness, randomly interrupted by scary bursts of disorder. And this is the point that Noel Sharkey is getting at. How would we even train a robot to react in such a situation? This would require an extremely large dataset with well-defined instances of good, bad, right, and wrong. This is how machines typically learn to perform better. For example, by continuously analyzing hundreds of millions of transactions, credit card firms have been able to improve their fraud detection algorithms. False positives and false negatives are now easily identified with almost 100% accuracy. But compared to being a soldier in a country that you're unfamiliar with, how do you decide whether to fire at unclear enemies? And how would a robot be able to satisfy the criteria in order to make that decision? And even if it were, how useful would a dataset like this be for invasions of places like Sudan and Yemen, just two of the many countries where the US has military bases? Given these challenges, it's difficult to avoid the conclusion that the concept of moral robotic killing machines is implausible and very likely to encourage harmful illusions of trigger wars and senseless killing. One thing is certain though, AI is evolving rapidly, and this means places like military, police, prisons, and security agencies have an increased interest in this technology. Military tactics that have been used in far-off conflicts and occupations frequently find their way back to the domestic front. They're used initially against unpopular or weak minorities before spreading to other groups. Local police departments have received tanks and armor from representatives of the US Department of Homeland Security. Sheriffs will be even more intrigued by AI-driven threat assessments and targeting. But it's crucial to keep in mind that there are numerous approaches to addressing societal issues. At this very second, the military-industrial complex is pushing towards the creation of autonomous drone swarms, claiming that only robots will be fast enough to foresee the enemy's counter-strategies. Now, when we look at this as a whole, this is a self-fulfilling prophecy. In an attempt to avoid being attacked by robots, we ultimately end up creating the robots that are going to be used to defend against attacking robots, thus creating the technology of killer robots. If we want to escape this self-destructive cycle, we have to examine the entire concept of teaching military robots about ethics. Former Pentagon officer Rosa Brooks writes in her book, How Everything Became War and the Military Became Everything, that there's a rising understanding among American defense specialists that development, governance, and humanitarian aid are at least as crucial to security as the use of force. A world with more real resources has less reason to pursue zero-sum wars. Additionally, it'll be better able to defend itself against natural foes like new coronaviruses. The US would almost probably have prevented tens of thousands of fatalities in 2020 if it had allocated even a small portion of its military budget to public health initiatives. And with that, we come to the end of this video. Now I'm really curious to know your guys' thoughts about killer robots in the comments, so please make sure to leave a comment letting me know what you thought of the video and of the topic. Do you think killer robots are going to take over the world soon? Or are they going to continue being science fiction and never become a reality? Thanks for watching all the way until the end. Make sure to click the like button and subscribe to our channel.